We are now in the late Cretaceous. The final stretch is near. As hinted in the previous episode, the Therocephalians were up to something special. From a mere anticoagulant saliva to a truly dangerous cocktail, the Bauriids have now developed venom. Such early toxins are capable of evolving into a variety of forms, such as a paralytic, horribly tingly neurotoxin, a necrosis-causing cytotoxin, or something that can cause blood to flow freely with no end, a hemotoxin. Our first star of today's episode is sort of a mixture of the first and last two, which allows it to be able to hunt down large insects and small vertebrates with terrifying success. Meet Primavenudon. Primavenudon was a humble creature. They mostly hunted speedy critters at or below their weight class, and they only ever bit anything large or significantly threatened. When compared to the beasts that will come later, they're rather innocent, despite the potential that they held within them. Things appeared to be stable for the beast heads, the first time in millions of years. This venom has really paid off. Yes, venom can be a potent tool for hunting the small and evasive, but it is expensive and cynodonts are still ravenous beasts. Their high metabolisms allow them to once again out-eat the Therocephalians. It seems familiar, doesn't it? Like a Tiltos from eons ago? It's as if the Bauriids are back where they started. Therocephalians at this time are more diurnal and a bit less fossorial than their foes from the same branch. Another one of the small disadvantages that will inevitably make a huge difference in the future. But what, do you think they just stand there and take it? Do you think after millions of years of fighting for their place in the world, they just let themselves fizzle out? No, that's insane. If they were going out of this world, they go out with a bang. So after trial and error, 23 million years, a steep decline in population and hundreds of iterations, something special has arrived. One of the most fearless Therocephalians to ever live. Vecorobauria. Vecorobauria's aposematic markings aren't just for show, for these beasts are hostile and the venom causes extreme agony when bitten. Even larger predators steer clear of it. With extremely potent venom, they're able to hunt and kill prey that's much larger than them. All they have to do is pounce, bite, and wait for their prey to bleed themselves dry due to powerful anticoagulants. Their favorite prey are the eggs and offspring of dinosaurs, being devastatingly effective at hunting them. They also fed upon the larger Mesozoic mammals with a fierce determination, a true menace of northern Africa. With nothing left to lose, the surviving Therocephalians rebounded for only one thing, vengeance. And vengeance they got. But one spring day, it all came crashing down.